there's a bombable wall here, obviously. Is there any doors that I can pop open by cutting these vines? I would doubt it. Especially when those doors would seemingly lead me back to where I was before. So, will that bomb? No, it won't. Okay, let's just go. Okay, what am I supposed to probably push? No, not that one. Okay, which one? Is it gonna be like... Could I push this one? I would doubt it. It looks like that I'm supposed to get in from the back way and come out the other way. So this wall is probably bombable. Or there's a door right there. That works. That was actually kind of obvious. That oh, shoot, there's two doors. Oh, okay, that's what I thought. There, because it was supposed to hint at that there was a door over here by letting you peek at what's to come. And there's a door over there, and there's a bombable wall up there. There's just paths all over the place in this dungeon. What the heck? My god! There's like three more doors that I can go in. This place is the most confusing dungeon ever. Okay, which of the two paths should I go now? The other way was probably the right way. Just a guess. Can I push this down? Okay, this way was the right way. So that works. And I gotta remember that I have to go back. Well, actually, that'll probably stay where it is. So I'm just gonna make you spring and go up this way. There's a treasure chest there. But that's not gonna help me right now because I can't get through there. So let's just go back. I was just curious as to where I was supposed to go there. And now I can kill Mr. Staphos, dude. Bomb this wall. And these blocks here will probably disappear at some point to lead me back. Or they're just there as like a red herring of some sort. And I can go through here. This leads me to a treasure chest with just a single red gem. And okay, there's three doors here I can see. Come on now. If I push this one up, will this give me anything? No. But there's a door over here. That'll lead me to this treasure chest. But there's a door over here. What the heck, man? How many places does this thing have? And that's not bombable, so that's okay. This leads me over to this big room. There doesn't appear to be any sort of... any doors here, is there? Because I don't see any doors from behind the ivy. Oh wait, down here is a door. Oh my god! There's the lantern, I could use that. Oh wait, I want to bomb other places, so I'll be back here. But that's where I need to go to get the lantern, I guess. So let's go to other paths. The other paths are probably for force gems. So that middle one's gonna lead me to a dead end. I'm gonna go up here. And is there... No, there's no door over there. But I can push this up anyway. Square formation. Was this... Oh, there is no door there. Okay, so I did take all the paths I could take. Awesome. Alright, back for the... Oops, wrong path. Back for the lantern. This way. Blocks they push, that's very nice and generous of them. Obviously, there isn't any other way to push the block, so I guess you can't necessarily screw yourself, you know, by blocking yourself in. And there's the lantern! And now I can light some stuff, and surprisingly, I can't push that. Okay, where is the simple way out? There we go. Out we go! Can I, just for the fun of it, no, I can't light those things. And I'm back out here. Let's try and light these things. I was gonna say land to these things. Force gems for the win! And this way, and then here's the shortcut back. So I might as well take advantage of that. I'm at 1,638 force gems, so I'm guessing that this level is coming to an end pretty dang soon. That's just my assumption, because usually when you get a lot of force gems from exploration, it just kind of like... hints that you're nearing the end just by your amount, because you're supposed to get 2,000 by the end, and that opens something up. What did I open up there? Oh, was it that door that was up there? No? Wait, what did I do by lighting all those? I completely missed it because I went up instead. That was stupid of me. So, let's light them again, just to make sure that I didn't miss anything here. So, okay. Bump. Okay, what did I do over there? Did I unlock something up here? Oh, there's more lanterns to I get it. I need to light all 8 of them in that room there. Okay, I gotcha. I can open this door by lighting those, and then now I can light all the lanterns simply by jumping down here. Okay. That makes a lot more sense. A lot more sense, Johnson. So, just lighting four more lanterns and see what the poop this unlocks. If anything, I don't know, I might be doing this for nothing. That did something, a load of force gems, so that was actually kind of useless. So what am I supposed to do with this lantern? I would guess I'm supposed to do something with this lantern. Wasn't there stuff that I could light in the dark world? Let's see if I can. Yep, there is. So let's go into the dark world, light this up. What the poop? It doesn't light in the dark world. Okay, so this is a dead end room? That wouldn't make much sense. Are these walls hollow? No. Okay, so that room is officially completely useless. At least I think it is. Well, anyway, there's some bombs and my bow that's still hanging up there. Oops. But, well, I guess it wasn't completely useless because now I can go back with the lantern and see what else I can light. But I don't remember there being anything that I could light, but I could be wrong. Could I light these ivy? No. That would have been kind of cool to kind of like light a wall full of ivy or something like that, just to go whoosh right across it. At least in my opinion, it would be. Okay, so what am I looking for around here? Well, there's a door there. I can see that there's some stuff to light across that wall. Oh, slingshots. I need the slingshot or the bow to hit the... Oh, actually, I just need the bow to get over and hit all those eyeballs across there. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. So let's go back, get our bow. This should be a quick trip back. And then I think I'm gonna have to drop the lantern, unfortunately. I love that sound. You've gotta love the chime of collection in Zelda World. It is such an awesome melody that will forever haunt your dreams of happiness and perhaps sorrow if you get a bad item or something like that. So let's go inside the door and let's try and hit those things across the... Oh, whoops, I'm just supposed to... There we go. Woo! And that should make a bridge of some sort, I would guess. Oh, it's an earthquake! Oh, there we go. Gemmy force gems! Me like triangular shiny things! And this should put me up to 2,000! Cha-ching! Hey-ya! Alright, up through the door we go. Now I need the lantern, dang it. Now I have to go back. Cut! Cut! There's your lantern. Ditch the bow. Come back here and light the torches. Let's see what's inside here. Oh, no! Evil floor tiles! Oh, my God! I'm sorry I called Pergo to do my flooring. I should have called someone else, I know, but Pergo is just cheaper than other brands, and I'm just so sorry. Oh, no! Oh, no. I bet you this is gonna make a skull, as it usually does. I'm gonna go into, is that a treasure chest that's attacking me? What the poop? And now there's the pots coming after me. Oh, my God. It's freaking chaos all over the place. Ah! What the heck? The whole room is coming down before me. Well, that was painful. But that was pretty hilarious at the same time. Quadruple Shadow Links! Give me Force Gems of Awesomeness. Well, let's give me a... Wow, 100 Force Gems for each of these suckers. Wow, wow, and wow. Okay, let's grab one of these. Throw it there. Woo! That was awesome, I gotta say. Through the door we go. And there's a whole load of mice. So I'm gonna go... Ow, horizontal. What the heck is... They're taking my Force Gems! How dare you! No! My Force Gems are being sapped from me! I must kill him before they get all my Force Gems, and I'm also near death, but that's okay. I got Force Fairies on my side. Oh, I died, but I got a Force Fairy. Give me... This is the first time I've died in the whole walkthrough, but I got 15 Force Fairies from that room anyway. So, I am back from the dead, and I am still gonna lose a ton of force gems because of those tang things. Yay! And I gained them all back from that bouquet of force gems that came down from the heavens. And, whoops, I'm supposed to open these up. Oh, wait, what? Why can't I open those? Wait, I need a special key for that treasure chest? Okay, let's go back to there. What the heck is this? What? I don't remember you. Oh, wait, maybe I do. Oh, okay, I believe I'm supposed to get rid of a shield first. Well, there's some hearts, but that's kind of useless to me. What am I supposed to... Because those are rocks, I have to do something, I'm sure. Whoops. Can I, like... Okay, that's useless. What if I go down here? Will this take me to the game... Yes, it will take me to the Game Boy Advance screen. Ah, oh, I missed the boomerang. So I guess I need the boomerang to smite my foe. So let's go drop down another hole. And... like so. And let's grab it and get out of here. I guess the boomerang is what I need to defeat him. Let's see. And... let's see what I have to do here. Can the boomerang just, like... can I just, like, take out... yeah, I can just take those rocks right out. Oh, okay. And then I'm supposed to kill him with my sword. That makes a lot more sense. But come to... maybe this boss does seem kind of familiar. Yeah. I'm gonna go into, like, this. And then so I can, like, mass slaughter the eyeballs. Ow. Ah, don't stop doing that. I would like to just kill the eyeballs safely, thank you. But I guess that's kind of your intent, is to not make it very safe for me to do so. Ah! I just fell down the hole. That was unfortunate. What are these pots? Nothing except for a force gem. And up we go! To the show of happiness and horizontal. Okay, not many of these boulders, or whatever you want to call them, left. Boulder eyeballs left. Yeah. Come on up. Let me kill you, please. I mean, I know you're afraid of death, but we all gotta die sometime. So come on, man. I've gotta take you out now before I go down. And time it. There we go. Okay, now what am I gonna do about you? Oh my god, he's ticked off. I'm not liking the looks of this. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Horizontal. This will give me a better chance. And he's bouncing around like those weird fire things, and that was completely useless. Can I just hit him with my sword? Yes, I can. Oh, that works for me pretty well. Awesome. Please don't make more rocks appear. Okay. Oh, Shockwave made me stun. Okay, aha! Eat my sword! You're going down, you sucker! And Shockwave of Death. Oh boy. He's getting faster, he's getting ticked, but when I hit him, he just gets stunned anyway, so that was kind of useless. If he needed to stun me, he's done! Force gem bouquet. Wow, that's a lot of force gems, actually. I've got 3,876 force gems. Holy poopers. And now I can rescue another maiden from the depths of the darkness. Whee! Yes, I defeated the stone eye thing. That's something that I called it, didn't I? Well, anyway, or at least it's something that I would call something. So I like that statement. I like this maiden, I have to say. Oh no, Death Mountain is next. That means lava and rocks and dangers. Oh my! The screen goes yellow. And now white. And a fairy looms above the lands, more like flies or floats. And another maiden has been freed. That makes me very happy. And I will now be able to continue the game in some other part. Well, that about does it for this part. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you in the next part, where we do level 3, whichever one that's gonna be.